Hi everyone. So Google Bard has introduced a new upload feature, and through this feature we will be able to upload any images of this JPEG, PNG and WebP format, and we will be able to get a response from that image. So it's basically like searching an image with the help of Google Lens, but with response with the help of AI. So it's basically like a combination of Google Lens mixed with artificial intelligence. So in this video, I'll be showing you some of the ways you can efficiently use this upload feature and get the maximum out of it. So I'm having these many images to show you as an example. So let's just begin with the first image. So the first image that I'm having here is a essay or summary on global warming. So this is just like a boring paragraph. So what we can do with the image is that I will just go to my Google Bard and I will just go here, upload file, and I'll just upload this thing over here. So this particular paragraph doesn't have any headings, right? So I'll just ask Google Bard to basically summarize this with much more neat headings. So I'll just go here and type summarize with headings. And I'll just hit enter. So here you can see that we are getting response with headings. What is global warming, causes of global warming, effects of global warming, and so much stuff with conclusion. And it has also taken some like sources from the net, but in our image we don't have anything. We just don't have any headings, but we just have the data over here. So this is one way of using this, and if you aren't satisfied with the response that you get, you can just scroll down, and here you'll be having a settings like icon in which you can click it, and here you can just click on modify this response. So based upon your use case, you can like click and regenerate another response. So this is the first way. And another way is, what if in case you want some questions? So the same thing, the same paragraph image that I have, and we need to generate some questions. So let's suppose say that you are a professor or a lecturer, or you're going to like conduct a seminar, you need to ask questions, right? So what if you want to generate some questions from this thing? So that can be done within a second by using this feature. So you can just go here, upload the same image, and just type generate 10 questions from this. That's it. Click on submit. So these are the questions that I got as a response from this image. What is global warming? What are the causes of global warming? So many things. So this is another use case by using this upload feature. And apart from this, there is another thing. So in case if you're having a flow chart or a workflow diagram like this, so this is basically Amazon's, you know, e-commerce delivery diagram. So you're having a workflow or a so-called flow chart diagram, and you want to just convert that particular diagram into paragraph or text, I think this is super useful. All right, so let's just try this out. So I'm just going to upload this particular image and ask Google Bard to generate a paragraph from this flowchart. This will be super handy if you're doing some PowerPoint presentations. So I'll just go here, upload this. I'm having this Amazon thing. Yeah, I'll just go here and side summarize into paragraphs. So this is the response that we get. Here you can see, right, here is the summary of the image of Amazon's supply chain. So it basically has like, you know, taken the heading from there, and here you can see the steps. So this is basically how it summarizes. And if you want to like have some headings, you can just ask summarize into paragraphs with headings. So it will surely give you with some headings and listed down the steps also. And you have this modify response also. So basically like you can just, you know, use the prompt based upon your use case. So next use case that I find more, you know, more amazing is solving mathematical problems. So here I'm having this problem, right? So I'll just now upload this and like ask it to solve for me. I'll just go here. This is that problem. I'll just put solve it and send it. And the solution to this problem is this one, x equal to 13 and x equal to 5. So we got the response. So here you can see, right, the solution is x or 5 and 13, the value of x, and this is the solution, x equal to 13 and 5. So this works great also. And another use case is locating or getting the description of an image. So I'll just go here and, you know, upload this picture of Eiffel Tower. Yeah, I did this tutorial yesterday also. So you can just like upload it and, you know, ask describe this picture. So here you can see, right, this is the picture you sent me, is a view of the Eiffel Tower. We get the river name, Paris, and more information. See this much, we literally get every statistics of the Eiffel Tower over here. And another thing that I find weird about this Google bot is that if I upload images of people, it is not giving me a proper response. So I'll just go here. I'm having this picture of Elon Musk, and I'm just trying to, like, you know, upload this picture, and I'm just, you know, and I'm just type name and describe 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 this person. You know, I'm just giving Elon Musk picture, and I'm asking him to just describe this picture. And this is the response that I get. It removes my image and it says, sorry, I can't help with images of people yet. I don't know why this is occurring, but this is the response that I get whenever I upload his picture or some other person's picture. I think Google will come up with a solution for this too. So these are some of the ways I find, you know, this upload feature of bot so handy. You can just try it out depending upon your use case, and you can surely mention in the comments below you have some better use cases other than this. I would love to know them. And do check the playlist of my channel. I've done many programming tutorials. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.